Welcome to Dental and Ayurveda, a channel for basic dental and basic Ayurvedic sciences. Our today's chapter is Dentifreezes, a chapter of Dental Pharmacology, DDS. Before starting, I would like to thank you all for your support. And इस chapter के ready-to-read notes available है हमारे Instagram page पे, जिसका link given है description box में.
So in this video, we are going to talk about dentifreezes. So these are actually the agents which you use along with the toothbrush to clean and polish the natural teeth. Now it can be available as tooth powder or toothpaste. So the preparation, if I talk about, so these are prepared in the very bulk powder form, generally containing a soap or detergent, mild abrasive and any anti-carcinogenic agent. Then what are the ideal properties for any oral preparation? So it should be non-toxic, non-caustic, okay, and non-decalcifying also. Over-abrasive bhi nahi hona chahiye. Then as I told you, it should be non-toxic or non-poisonous to the body. Then it must not have, it must not inhibit the secretion and alter the reaction of saliva. And it should not destroy the ferments of saliva. Then what all properties it should have? That it should have, pleasant taste, odor should be fine, and consistency should be also fine. Then sufficient cleansing action should be there. Then various ingredients used to prepare toothpaste and tooth powder, you can these are here. First is the any abrasive agents must be there. Then detergents, which are used as cleaning agents. So let's talk about detergents. So classification on the basis of their action, their mechanism, is first is your sodium bicarbonate. So how it acts? It acts by dissolving the proteins, and it is a mild alkali. Ye mild alkali hota hai. Then hydrogen peroxide, it acts by liberating oxygen. And if I talk about hard soaps, so these are going to act, ye surface tension ko lower kar dete hai. And these are prepared by heating any vegetable oil or fatty acids with sodium hydroxide. Then they are grayish white or yellowish white in color. Then available as odorless solid or powder ke form mein present milte hain hame hard soaps. And they are partially soluble in water and they are completely soluble in alcohol. So water mein to ye partially soluble honge, while in alcohol it is completely soluble. Then these are incompatible with strong acid and heavy metal salts. So inki ye incompatible hote hain strong acids ke sath ya jo heavy metal salts hote hain unke sath. Then proportion of hard soap in most tooth powders and toothpaste is like 5 to 25%. And their hard soaps have many multipurpose actions, like it can act by dissolving fatty substances, mucus plaques and lowering the surface tension, as I told you. Then it causes loosening of debris adhering to the teeth. So teeth mein jitna bhi debris hai usko loosen karta hai. So it helps in cleaning. Then it acts as a lubricant when it is scrubbed over the teeth and gums. Sodium and sapomolys, sapo enamels. So all these, you can see, these are the hard soaps and these are used for preparing tooth powder and toothpaste. Then since you can see saponins, example is you can see Senegal, Kilesia, then etc. There are much more examples. So they are going to lower the surface tension and they can also be used as cleaning agents. Then perborates, these are substances which oxygen liberate karte and they act as a deodorant. Then we talk about antiseptics. So in dentifreezes, the value of antiseptic jo hoti hai, antiseptic ki value itni zyada nahi hoti. Why? Because it can be used in very little amount only. Due to safety reasons, हमें इसे ज़्यादा amount में use नहीं कर सकते. Common antiseptics अगर हम देखें तो can be methanol, eugenol, volatile oils हो जाते हैं, ये सारे volatile oils हैं. Then we have benzoic, potassium chloride, xylol, acid, okay. Then boric, magnesium and calcium peroxide. So these are all antiseptics only. Then we talk about the sweetening agents. So sweetening agents, you must have heard about saccharine sodium also. So saccharine is commonly used sweetening agent hai, and the other sweetening agent that is sucrose and lactose. So if I talk about saccharine sodium, so ye ek white color ka crystalline sa hota hai powder, okay, with intensely which is paste and soluble 1 in 1.5 of water and 1 in 50 of alcohol. So now it is used as a synthetic sweetening agent ki tarah hum use karte hain. So saccharine sodium jo hai, we use it as synthetic sweetening agent. Then it is more palatable and free from aftertaste of saccharine, so no food value, okay. Then so it can be used in place of glucose or sucrose. So diabetic patients ke liye, kyunki iski food value nahi hai, so it is very very fine for diabetic patients ke liye bahut sahi hai, to hum diabetic patients ko dete hain. Then its daily intake should not exceed 1 gram, or and agar hum baat kare daily intake ki, so it should not be taken more than 1 gram per day. Now it has carcinogenic effect and it may cause cancer of bladder, and that's why we do not exceed its amount per day more than 1 gram. Then coloring agents we use, so commonly used coloring agents are liquor azurbri, and you can see liquor rubri. Then you have tincture cocci, so these are going to impart the red color. Then methylene blue, it is used to impart blue color, and magenta is used to give red color to, you know, any acid mouthwashes. Jo bhi acid mouthwashes hote hain unko dete hain color. So you can see the three coloring, matlab three colors, like for red we use certain things and magenta used for acid mouthwashes ko red color dene ke liye.
Thank you for watching. Do like, share and subscribe. और कमेंट बॉक्स में हमें ज़रूर बताइएगा कि और ऐसे कौन से टॉपिक्स हैं जिन पे हम वीडियो बनाएं.